how we started off. And I didn't tell you how I went to IIS to start with and how I went into this area to start with. Basically, I was looking for a project on computer graphics. I was very, very keen about getting into computer science and computer graphics. So the only title, only project which was offered among all the listed on the board was one had computer graphics for something. I didn't look at what something, but I said, whatever it is, I don't care, computer graphics, I'm doing that. So it turned out to be computer graphics for metal casting applications. So I found the hotspot, and then as luck would have it, I went to Germany. That was my first flight, was international flight. I simply went from Bangalore to Germany to present my research. It's a different story how I got money to buy my ticket and how did I stay and all those things are different stories. But eventually I developed the thing in three dimensions. Remember, this was the very first lot of IBM PCs which came in India, 1986-87. I learned how to program in three dimensions. It was not easy because you can still draw dots on the screen. You have to draw areas and three dimensions, so I had to figure out that. And eventually, before I left IAC, it was actually commercialized. Okay, but it was had its own limitations. So once I joined IIT, I still had this dream that can I make a better version of that, a much more comprehensive version of that. So if, as I say, when you desire something very greatly, you know, things come in your way. So I had this student called Ramesh and this senior gentleman called Mohan. They both came. Ramesh said, I'll program, and Mohan said, I'll fund the development. And so we created the first proper commercial software called AutoCast. Why AutoCast? Because it starts with A. So I thought A will get listed first always. And talking about automatically analyzing, it was like an AI kind of program for metal casting. So we did that. The very first couple of licenses were sold to actually foreigners. First went to Japan, the second went to USA, Ford Motor Company. One Professor Kreese, who was kind of my PhD thesis foreign reviewer, he helped me to get a contact in Ford. We went to Ford, installed that, demonstrated that. That was a great experience. So that was, I think, about in late 90s. And so year after that, we started doing different versions. We had version 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And eventually, we could develop much better features. We used to run every September courses for industry with hands-on experience onto that. And I can tell you stories about that. There's one place where we used to do one course. This was in Hosur, between Bangalore and Chennai. And I remember there was about 80-year-old person who was in the room. We just take computers and put everyone on a computer and say, now you start doing simulation, three-dimensional simulation. And there was this guy, 80-year-old person, who was sitting on a stool in a corner. So I assumed he was attendant first. And then I was looking around, and then I got a doubt. So I asked him, who are you? He said, I'm a participant. I said, why are you not sitting on a computer? He said, no, I can't sit on a computer. So we finally got him, made him sit on the thing. I asked someone to teach him. And he was trying to touch the computer screen. Please remember, this was in 90s or early 2000s. I said, no, this is not a touch screen. Touch screen were not invented yet at that point of time. So I teach him how to move the mouse. I said, move the mouse, click the mouse, then the menu will go and so on. So he started using that. After a few minutes, he was, I was helping others, and I went back and saw he had tears flowing through his eyes. So I thought maybe the brightness is too much and his first time using computers, right? So I asked people to reduce the brightness. So then he said something in Tamil and I couldn't understand. Then they translated for me. And he said, literally he said that I can now die in peace because for the last 50 years, I have been pouring metal into molds. I had no clue what happens once metal goes into the mold because molds are made of sand. You can't see inside. Now I know what happens inside. So I have stories like that, many, many stories like that. So this really touches your heart. I mean, you feel that even if one person, you know, feels happy about what you created a product, to be able to simulate and create better products and even get an insight.